Hello students, welcome to Shourav sir's classes. In today's video, we will be solving questions from JEE Main 2019 question paper. We'll start this video by solving question number 12, question number 14. And question number 14 is a probability theory question, that is, let A and B be the two non-null events such that A is a subset of B, then which of the following statement is always correct? So if A is a subset of B and A and B are two non-null events, non-null means these two events are not null events, that is, these at least contains one element. So null event contains no element, so this is non-null events, that means A and B contains at least one element. So if A is a subset of B, then probability of A given B, probability of A given B will be probability of A intersection B divided by probability of B. We know that this is the formula of probability of A given B. So as A is a subset of B, so B is a bigger set and A is a smaller set, so we can write probability of A given B as probability of A. And probability of B as probability of B. So probability of A given probability of B. So probability of A given B becomes probability of A divided by probability of B, which is not equals to probability of A, because probability of B will not be equals to 1 as A and B are two non-null events, that means something will remain in A. So probability of B cannot be 1 here, hence probability of A divided by probability of B will not be equals to probability of A. And probability of A divided by probability of B will be greater than or equals to probability of A. Probability of A divided by probability of B will be greater than or equals to probability of A. Because probability of B here is a fraction and probability of A is also a fraction. So if we divide probability of A by a fraction, so it will be more than probability of A. So let's say probability of A is 0.2. So now if we divide it by 1, it will remain 0.2. But if we divide it by 0.5 or something like fractional value, it will be multiplied, it will become 4. 0.4. So this is the reason why probability of A divided by probability of B is greater than or equals to probability of A always. So answer will be option 2. Probability of A given probability of B is greater than or equals to probability of A. So we have solved question number 14 here, and now we'll move towards question number 15. If alpha and beta be the two roots of the equation x square minus 2x plus 2 equals to 0, then the least value of n for which alpha by beta whole to the power n will be equals to 1 is how much? So you have to find the least value of n for which alpha by beta whole to the power n will be equals to 1. So the equation is given as x square minus 2x plus 2 equals to 0. We can write it as x minus 1 whole square is equals to minus 1, because x square minus 2x plus 1 is x minus 1 whole square, and another plus 1 will remain here, so we will shift that to the right hand side and x minus 1 whole square will become as minus 1. So x minus 1 whole square is equals to minus 1, and the minus 1 is the value of, we know, the value of I square. Minus 1 is the value of I square. So we can write it in the form of x minus 1 whole square is equals to I square. or x minus 1 whole square minus I square is equals to 0. And similarly, in the this will be in the formula of a plus b into a minus b. So x minus I, x minus 1 plus I into x minus 1 minus I will be equals to 0. This is a square minus b square equals to 0. This is a plus b into a minus b equals to 0. This is the same formula because a square minus b square equals to a plus b into a minus b. So we have got x. X can take two values. From here we can write that x minus 1 plus I equals to 0 or x minus 1 minus I equals to 0. So x can take two values. X can be either 1 minus I or x can be 1 plus I. So x can take two values, 1 minus I or 1 plus I. And now let the two values of x name as alpha and beta. Let alpha is equals to 1 plus I and beta is equals to 1 minus I. So alpha by beta whole to the power n. So alpha by beta whole to the power n. Whole to the power n, sorry. Because it is given that alpha beta are the two roots of the equation. Alpha beta are the two roots of the equation, and we have got that the two roots are 1 minus I and 1 plus I. So we have denoted alpha as 1 plus I and beta as 1 minus I. So alpha by beta whole to the power n is equals to 1. Let me change the pen color. So 1 plus I, basically 1 plus I divided by 1 minus I whole to the power n is equals to 1. Now if we solve this, if we express this in terms of E, we can write root over of 2, root 2 e to the power I into pi by 4 divided by root over of 2 into e to the power minus I pi by 4 whole to the power n will be equals to 1. So e to the power root 2 and root 2 will be cancelled out. Root 2 and root 2 will be cancelled out. E to the power I pi by 4 minus e to the power minus I pi by 4, because this the power of e to the power e will be subtracted from each other. So e to the power I into pi by 4 minus I into pi by 4 will become e to the power I n pi by 2. Because this is I pi by 4 and this is minus of I pi by 4. So minus and minus will be plus. Hence e to the power I n pi by 2 will be equals to 1. As e to the power I into n pi by 2 is equals to 1, so n will be equals to 4. So n will be equals to 4. So 4 is the correct answer for question number 15. So we have solved question number 14 and 15 in this video. If you have any doubt or any queries, you can feel free to call us in this number 9836793076, or you can send us email also at sourabsirclasses@gmail.com. This is our email address. You can call us anytime or you can send us email. Thank you.